So let's start. Hello, myself Sukanta from IIT Guwahati, India. I am a final year PhD candidate in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at IIT Guwahati. So title of my today's talk is Reliability Aware Framework for On-Chip Power Grid Design Using Deep Learning. So Sukumar, Nandi and Gaurav, Trivedi are my supervisors and this is my website. So this is the outline of my talk. So initially I will talk about on-chip power planning and what is motivation in today's scenario. Then I will talk about the non-linear optimization formulation of the power grid design problem. So after that I will discuss about my proposed work and then I will show you the results, and after that I will conclude my work. So modern day VLSI size and complexity are increasing, as you can see in the slide. So the number of transistors are for a mobile SoC is crossing 10 billion, and in future the number of transistors for a simple mobile processor will be 20 billion or so. So how this teaser design? So basically initially RTL synthesis are done. So after the synthesis they make the layout, and in the layout making stage floor planning is the main stage where all the function blocks are planned and how these function blocks are placed and routed. That the planning is done in the floor planning stage. So how this will be done? This is basically done in the floor planning stage, and here one of the important and central role plays power planning phase. Power planning plays a central role in this floor planning stage. So in this power planning stage, the main aim is to create the power grid design, and also the power grid that the design, the main thing what they need to take care of is the airdrop and electromerchant margin of this power grid network. So what is a power grid network? So power grid network transfers power from power pads to the function blocks in a system on chip. So in this diagram you can see this is the functional blocks, and this is a power pad, 1.8 volt power pad. So if the power needs to transfer from this 1.8 volt to this function blocks, then some grids, metal grids are constructed with the help of this grid. The power is transferred from this power pad to the function blocks. However, there are some issues, as I discussed, as I said in the previous slide, due to this metal resistance, parasitic capacitances and inductances of these metal lines, there is some amount of voltage drop occurs. So if this voltage drop goes beyond a certain threshold or certain threshold, then this malfunction, this function blocks may not work. So it is very important to check for this air drop margin, and also what is the current flowing through each of the metal lines, that also need to be checked, or else there will be electromigration violation. So these two violations need to be focused while designing this power grid network. So how this power grid network is designed? That is done in the on-chip total power planning phase. So power planning starts with the pin placement phase of the power ground pins, power network is generated in order to provide power to standard cells and macros within the acceptable error drop margin. Steady state error drop occurs due to the resistance of the metal wires of the power grid network. Error drop can be reduced by decreasing the voltage differences between different nodes, which is determined by the power grid analysis. RD, so if this margin is satisfied, then they go for the placement and route of the blocks. So RD factor is done in order to find the error drop even before the placement routing stage with the power information from the front end design. Once the margin of the error drop is satisfied in this stage, then the placement and routing are done. Subsequently, vector power grid is performed with the current true current traces of the underlying functional blocks in order to satisfy the error drop margin. Now, once all the margins are satisfied, then the power friends, then it is called the power things remaining sign off. So it is a very lengthy process and lots of alterations are there. So what we'll do, we'll try to replace this whole power planning phase using a deep learning, a machine learning approach, and where we will not be using any power grid analysis method. So the related works and motivation. So many works in laser literature are there. There are many works in the literature in the last two decades which deals with power grid design, analysis and optimization and verification using different heuristics. However, there is no significant work in the literature using the deep learning or machine learning technique. And all the methods that mentioned above suffer from large convergence time. So basically our motivation is to reduce this convergence times of this power planning phase. Also, in order to it has been proved that deep learning is successful in predicting complex tasks. So we want to use this deep learning for this power grid and analysis, power grid design problem. And why so? Because we have found that there is an equivalence between this power grid design and the deep learning training problem. So our major contribution in this work, we are the first to present the power planning methodology using this deep learning approach. And we also present a new aspect of obtaining similarity between the power grid design and deep learning in the VLSI physical design cycle. So at the VLSI physical design level, we answer the following questions. So how much practically feasible deep learning is for the power planning phase? And how accurately can the deep learning approach predict different design parameters while still satisfying the allowed error drop and electromigration margin? Also, the third question we answered is, what is the efficiency of the deep learning approach compared to the standard power planning phase? So overview of the proposed approach. So our objective here is to reduce the iterative flow of the power planning phase while still satisfying the allowed margin of error drop and electromigration with the help of historical data generated in the design process of the power grid network. So basically we will use the historical power grid data and specification. From there we will do the fetch instruction and training data generation. After that we will use this training data to train a neural network, and then we, for a new power grid data and specification, we will create a test data, and for that test data we will predict our model's efficiency and we will show the results. That's what our basic overview of the proposed approach. So now come to this nonlinear optimization formulation.
So here what we'll show that we show that there is an equivalence between this, there is equivalence between this power grid design and the deep learning training. So it has been well, it has been proved that in the literature, the deep learning training is a the object is a non-linear task. So the objective of the power grid design is to obtain the optimum width of the power grid lines considering different reliability constraints. And for any power grid line, the basic equation forms is this. For any where Wi is the width of the power grid, and rho is the sheet resistance of the metal line of the metals. Li is the length of the power line. I is the current through that power line, and this is the IR draw. So this is how the conventional design is done, and also there are some other constraints which needs to be followed. However, in order to find this current and this IR drop, we need to do the power grid analysis, which is a very time consuming task. So what needs to be done is we need to so using conventional method, it will take a lots of time, and also this problem is a non-linear problem. If we consider this I as a constant, suppose as I is a constant, then Li and Li by VIR, it forms a nonlinear problem. So there is an equivalence between this power grid design problem and the deep learning training problem. So these two method, that's why there is a very much equivalence. So in this deep learning training, there will be X level data set will be there. It will be fed to the neural network, and it will predict Y dash, and then the error function will be killed. From the error function, the error of this prediction value is created, and then the using the back progression, the mini of this error is minimized, and the weights of this neural networks are updated, and we get the optimum weight of the neural network for which this neural network gives the true prediction with very high confidence score. Similarly, what in this our power design, what we'll do for each of the interconnect data, we have the known width for each of the interconnects, and we will feed this to the neural network, and we will predict, we will get a predicted width for each of the interconnects. Then we will obtain the error for each of the interconnects, and we use back propagation to minimize this error, and in this way we train the neural network to predict the wire width of the power grid interconnects with very high confidence score. And this C is the, this is basically the constraints, this IR drop constraints and electromagnetic constraints incorporated using this C here. So after that, so we basically from there we designed two problems. So first problem is given xy coordinate and the switching characteristic of the function drop, then predict the metal width required which satisfy IR drop and IR margin for that particular location, and given the width and ID, predict the IR drop of the given this width, this basically given the width which we obtain from this problem one and the current switching current, then predict the IR drop of the PG interconnect. So these are the two problems. So for that we need, so as we see in the, our previous, as we see in our previous here, we will be doing this feature extraction and training data. So we will be explaining each of the steps in the previous, in the next slides. So in the feature selection and training data, so R square score is evaluated. So what is R square? So R square score or coefficient of determination is a metric which shows the goodness of the prediction for the regression method. A value closer to 1 is desired for the data to fit in the model properly. So we calculated this R square for each of the power grid interconnects. So we basically extracted the data from IBM processor for we extracted the power grid from the IBM processor, and for each of the interconnects we try to find the R square score using different features, and basically what we found suitable for our input feature is this XY coordinate of the function blocks, and this ID is the current density, current switching current. This is this current switching versus current of the functional blocks. This info we get from the RTL front end design, and we have found that if we take this 3 as an input feature, and this WI is the width of the power grid width of a power grid interconnect. If we take this combination as the as our feature input and output, then we get the high amount of R square as shown from this figure. So as you can see, this red dots are the combined features. When we combine the feature, then the R square we get a high R square, basically, which means that the if we select this as our features, then we get a good model fitting for the data. So we take this as features, and we created the training data, and we used a neural network. So what type of neural network we what is a neural network? The neural network has is three there are three different kinds of layer. One is input layer, one is output layer, and one is hidden layer. In hidden layer, there can be many numbers of hidden layers. We have found that by doing hyperparameter optimization, the 10 layer gives out the optimum result. And for optimizing the error of the predict or attained error width, we use this Adam optimizer. Then we train using our training data generated, and we then subsequently we test data is generated created by perturbing the training data set, and the performance is tested. So here is the block diagram. So basically we this PG netlist. But these are extracted from IBM processor, and these are available online. You can use. So from here, training dataset is created. So basically, this XY coordinate, switching current, and the width. Okay. And then we train the neural network, and for the test data we perturbed, we basically change this 10% of nodes or 20% of nodes, and this test dataset is created. And this, we use this forward propagation and this back propagation to update and to obtain the widths of the neural network, optimum widths of the neural network. And then for the here we calculate the mean square error and the R square score. So after that we use the with the post processing of the interconnects to find the airdrop, and for that we use this predicted width as the input, and use this switching current ID as the input also in the input, using Kirchhoff's law for all the interconnects, and in all the including all the branch and the network, we found the current and the voltage, and basically we found the airdrop. So then we reported this basically. So the reason, so we use this IBM benchmarks. And as you can see, so these are the number of nodes of the IBM networks, and these are the number of resistances, and these are the number of voltage sources connected to this now power grid network, and these are the current sources as model, which are modeled as the current sources. So we use these data sets. IBM bench to create the training data and also the trace data, and we tested our algorithms. So the study of predicted weeks. So here we the correlation between the predicted width of the power grid using our proposed method and the conventional approach is evaluated. From the correlation value, it can be seen how much the predicted widths are correlated to the golden width. Here, golden width obtained from the conventional approach. The correlation plot is shown in the figure. To study the error distribution of the predicted width, error histogram plot is shown. Also shown from the error histogram, we can observe that most of the predicted widths are concentrated near zero, which means most of the predicted widths of the PG interconnects produce near about zero error. So zero error for most of the interconnects. So that is what, as the amount of error increases, the number of power instances decreases. From this result, we can conclude that the predicted width of the power grid lines using the power planning DL are very close to the golden results generated by the conventional approach for most of the interconnects. So here we show them, here I have shown the convergence time. So the convergence time for both of the approaches shown. The convergence time of the conventional approach includes the airdrop analysis time, as it is the primary time consumed in each task. For our proposed approach, the convergence time shows the prediction time of the width and the airdrop time, airdrop prediction time. It can, from the table, it can be seen that our proposed approach is 5.87x faster for the IBM PG5 benchmark. It is also observed that for larger benchmarks, the speedup is more as larger grids take more time for power grid analysis in conventional approach, which is not used in our proposed framework. That is one of the main reasons that we get a significant speedup for our proposed approach compared to the conventional approach. We achieve the speedup at the cost of accuracy. It is to be noted that for the convergence time of the conventional approach reported in the table, we have considered the base case scenario and reported the convergence time only for one iteration of the design cycle. In the worst case, there can be multiple iterations of the design cycle for which the conventional approach takes much more time, whereas the convergence time will be the same for our proposed framework in all scenarios. This also shows the advantage of our proposed framework in reducing the number of iterations in the design cycle. So study of the predicted airdrop. So using the conventional approach, this is using conventional approach, and this is using the proposed work. So in both the results, almost same quality of results we have got. So here we have measured the mean square error. So for the test data, when the perturbation is only 10%, we get around 2-3% mean square error. Well, while the 30 the perturbation is increased from 30% to 30%, this MEC has increased, which shows that for the incremental design, our method is the best. Incremental design where a little changes are required, our method is the best. So in summary, so we have proposed a deep learning based framework to predict the initial power grid design. So for the first time, we have shown the equivalence between the neural network training and power grid design. We predict the power grid interconnect week as part of the design process, which is time consuming and tedious work. Subsequently, you also anticipate the worst case airdrop in the power grid. A neural network based multi-regression technique is used in our model for accomplishing the prediction task. Results using the IBM power grid shows So from the results of the experiment, we can recommend that our proposed work project same quality of results as that of the conventional approach, as seen in the eyedrop map. We also show that our proposed method is based for the incremental design, as we have very low mean square error for small perturbation. We also show that our proposed work is fast convergence in 5 to 6 speedup. And we also show that we have a low error rate for the 2% or around 2% mean square error. And future direction of research, better learning approach can be adapted. So for example, generative adversarial network or even landing belt techniques can be adapted for this power grid design. New objectives such as decay budgeting, electromigration can be adapted for this power grid problem. Accelerators for large designs, parallel and GPU based, can also be explored. Other CAD version logic design problems can be explored using this deep learning technique. And that is, and thank you. This is my QR code. You can get my website by scanning this QR code, or you can contact me at this sukanta.de@iitg.ac.in mail. So that's all. See you.